Alright, welcome back. On to part two of this VHS update. And I'm going to start this off with Uncle Sam. I realize this has been released on Blue Underground DVD, but I just haven't gotten around to getting it yet. I will eventually get it, but I just had to pick this up. I found it at Goodwill for $1, so I figured I might as well pick it up. Pretty cool cover art. Don't know how the movie is, but just glad to have this in the collection finally. So yeah, it's Uncle Sam, and that's a it's directed by William Lustig and written by Larry Cohen. So next up we have a really sun faded copy of Waxwork. That looks really bad. That's what it's supposed to look like. Everybody knows about Waxwork. I got this at a place called Total Video in my area, and they had these on sale for $1, so I figured I'd just pick it up. That's that. Waxwork. Haven't seen the movie yet, or the second one. I believe it's the second one, yeah, but anyway. Next up we have Don't Answer the Phone. I do have this on DVD already, but I figured I just might as well pick it up. I like the cover art. It's sun faded, but again, just nice to have on VHS. Released by Media. And that's that. And then next up we have Kicks. I hadn't heard about this movie until I saw it on KNJHorror.com's videos, where he's going through his rack showing his movies, and this movie looked interesting, and I stumbled upon it at the Total Video where I got these other two, so I picked it up for $1. Don't even know if it's really a horror film, really, but I saw it in KNJ's video, so I'm assuming it is. Maybe I shouldn't assume like that, but I don't know, I figured I'd just pick it up. It was $1, so it's got some pretty interesting cover art. Chick laying in bed with a big snake coming up. I don't know, maybe they're hinting at something, but anyway, I got more to show down here. I'm just going to grab them. This next bunch I'm going to show, I picked up at an antique shop. They were kind of overpriced, like $4 each, $3 each, some of them. But I got a few. They had quite a bit. Some decent stuff. Picked up the Willies. Haven't seen this yet. I've heard people talk about it in some of the videos. I figured I just might as well get it. Apparently it's a Blockbuster, former Blockbuster rental videotape. Oh, it's taped, so I can't get it out. But yeah, it's the Willies. It's got that dude chilling on the back. Chunky kid chilling with some maggots in his bed. I don't know. I don't know, I can't wait to check that out though. Heard a lot about it. Next up we have the original Wicker Man, starring Christopher Lee. I have this on DVD, actually. I haven't showed it yet in the update. It's one of those ones I bought like a year ago and still haven't shown yet. But I found this at that same antique shop for $4. And it's released under Media. And looks pretty old. I'm just glad to have this in my VHS collection finally. And next up we have The Howling 2. It's an interesting cover art that I've never seen before for this movie. I'm used to the DVD cover art. I could have sworn it's different. Maybe it's not, but that's that. I haven't seen this. I haven't seen any of The Howlings. Kind of ashamed to say, but I just figured I might as well pick this up. And I saw it, and I don't know when I'm going to see it again anywhere, so that's that. Gotta love that cover art. Picked up the same place, the Devonsville Terror, released by Embassy Home Entertainment. Looks interesting. Looks like it's about witches and stuff like that. Let's see. Is that Donald Pleasant? Looks like Donald Pleasant's right there. Yep, that's him. But yeah, I haven't seen this either. Don't know much about it. I know it was a double feature on some DVD. I think it was the Boogeyman, the original Boogeyman. But yeah, couldn't pass this up. Looks like it was used to be at like Hollywood Video or something, based on that sticker. And then next up we have Halloween 3. I picked this up on DVD like months ago. Haven't gotten around to watching it yet, but figured I might as well pick it up, just like the other ones, because I don't know when I'd ever see it again. This is a Good Times release. I don't know how many other releases they have of this, but I've never seen a cover for this of Halloween 3, so I figured, cool, pick it up. Get it. And then the last thing I picked up at that same antique shop was this Nightmare on Elm Street's Dream Master Part 4, released under Media, and I always love this cover art. Even back in the day when this first came out, I remember seeing the movie posters. I think this and Part 3 are my favorite movie arts for the Nightmare on Elm Street series, by far. They had other ones, but they were like the reissues of the VHS where it had the new updated cover art. It was kind of boring. I always like these drawings on here. They're just very well made, very creepy. But yeah. And I haven't gotten around to getting the Nightmare on Elm Street box set on DVD yet. I'm waiting for them to come out with them on Blu-ray. I guess that's what I'm waiting for. But anyway, this next bunch is from a flea market I went to today. Everything was either 50 cents each or 75 cents each. So, go and show you. Pick up the HBO Canon video release of Dawn of the Dead. And this cost me 50 cents. So, I really, really could not pass this up. There's that. Awesome. And next up we have The Fly, the Cronenberg version. I already got this on Blu-ray, showed it already. Covers beat to shit, but it was 50 cents, so I'm not gonna not get it, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, it's good to have. And then we have Scream, which I see everywhere on VHS. I saw like 6 copies at that antique shop where I got those other videos. So I wasn't in a rush to get it, but I picked it up today because the price was right. It was 75 cents, and it had this different cover that I'd never seen, so I figured I'd pick it up. I always see that other cover, obviously, but this is good to have. I haven't gotten around to getting these on DVD yet, so I don't know when. They'll always be around, so I'm in no rush, obviously, but excuse me. And then this I picked up. My Demon Lover. I don't even know if this would be considered horror. It just looks more like a really strange comedy. Maybe it is horror, I guess. I don't know. I picked it up for 75 cents. Never heard of it until I saw it today. Yeah. Looks cheesy as hell, but 75 cents, couldn't pass it up. And then next up we have, let's see, Haunted Honeymoon. This is more like a comedy, I guess. I don't know. Whatever, it was 75 cents, so I picked it up. It looked interesting. I had never seen it before, so anyway, next up, Graveyard Shift, Stephen King's Graveyard Shift, 75 cents, cover's all jacked, like somebody spilled coffee or something, it's all warped, but might as well pick it up, right? What's that? Some pretty cool cover art, I do say so myself. And then, a common one I see all the time. I Know What You Did Last Summer. Might as well. 75 cents. Picked it up. It's got the shiny cover. And then this next set here. Picked up at Goodwill. Actually, I picked up at Goodwill today. Sleepwalkers, Stephen King movie, never seen it. I've seen pieces of it, but I figured might as well pick it up. It's a buck. And got The Shining classic on this on Blu-ray. Looks great on Blu-ray, by the way. But yeah, might as well pick it up. It's a buck. And Creepshow, which I just recently picked up on Blu-ray as well. Yeah, might as well pick it up, right? A buck. And I'll go ahead and cut it off there. And there's a few more I'm going to show, and that'll be in the next part. So catch you guys then. Peace.